Hi, I'm Andrew Neal. I'd like to share with you beautiful people my story, my struggles with mental illness, and my silver linings and dark clouds.
I'd like to start off with the original song I wrote called Drum Song.
Suffered a traumatic brain injury. I had suffered from depression before the crash, but the crash itself really negatively affected my mental health. Fast forward a couple years, and I would experience a full-blown psychotic episode. It was a rainy summer day, and I had been awake for about 3 days. I was manic, to say the least. I'll always remember, in my driveway there was a turtle, and perhaps God was telling me to slow down, for my mind was racing faster than a cheetah. I decided to make some music, and that's when the lack of sleep really caught up with me. I had long hair that I mistook for other people around me. I yelled, "Get away, get away, get away," and felt very unsafe. I thought these people were trying to stop me from writing songs, triggering a fight or flight response. So I started to fight. I punched the walls and made huge holes in the walls. The noise of me yelling and punching the walls caused my younger brother Kyle to come downstairs and see what was happening. I was now in the kitchen and my mom and Kyle were both there, and I thought they were imposters wearing suits that looked like my mom and Kyle, but underneath there were other people. I didn't think they were my real family. My thoughts were racing. I saw a knife, and before I knew it, I tried to rip one of their suits. I stabbed my brother Kyle in the arm. When I saw the blood, I was shocked because, to be honest, I was expecting to see fluffy material from the suit. I dropped the knife and just wanted to go to sleep. The biggest nightmare of my life had just begun. My mind had erupted like a volcano. Even though volcanoes cause destruction, the remaining volcanic ash does provide a lot of nutrients for soil, which can help future growth. Because of this eruption, I would finally have a chance for treatment and therapy. I would start a new life and rise from the ashes. The first step was living my apology, taking responsibility for my actions, taking responsibility for my mental health, receiving forgiveness from Kyle, receiving forgiveness from my family, and receiving forgiveness from myself. The song I'm about to play right now is called Sorry Kyle, because the first thing you gotta do to be forgiven is say you're sorry and live it.
Last night I cried, now I smile.
Spending 6 months in jail before receiving sustained mental health treatment. Those days being locked away were indeed very, very dark, but it created in me a heart of appreciation. I am blessed because my mom, my family, including Kyle, never gave up on me and loved me unconditionally. As it says in the Bible, love never fails. Everyone makes mistakes. It's what people do with them that sets them apart. So what am I doing with the mistakes I made when my mental illness overwhelmed me? I tried to live each day by being a winner. I came up with the acronym WIN, what is necessary. Loving myself and forgiving myself, loving others and forgiving others, moving forward with hope is necessary. Living each breath with an attitude of gratitude and positivity is necessary. Pursuing a dream, in my case songwriting, is necessary. What is necessary? Ask yourself this. You know, we heard it said before that actions speak louder than words. And if actions speak so loud, why don't we listen to them more often? And be proud of our good actions, no matter how seemingly mundane. I took my meds today, victory. I showed up to work on time today, victory. I noticed something beautiful in nature today, victory. I'm reaching out to other people, not isolating, victory. I exercised today, took a power walk, victory. I drank enough water today, victory. I'm keeping up with my hygiene routine, victory. I cooked a good meal, victory. I'm radiating positive vibes into the universe, building myself and other people up, victory. Success builds upon success, my mom says, and she sure is right. Day after day, remind yourself of your successes and your victories. As it says in the Bible, be transformed by the renewal of your mind. There's no better renewal than the acknowledgement of your beauty and the acknowledgement of your victories. To me, my mental illness in many ways tries to divide and conquer me. What I mean is it twists my mind and makes me not trust other people, like my loved ones. It makes me isolate and not experience love. I thought my brother was an imposter in a suit, and fear conquered my mind. What is necessary? It's necessary for all of us to lean on each other and love each other. Together we win, together we are stronger. And I'll end this with a song called Divide and Conquer, and hope we can all say without a doubt a line from the song, I love you and I love me. Thank you.